viewers, we have Miss Nadia, who is the Deputy Director for Diaspora Affairs of the President's Office. Good afternoon, Nadia. How are you
good
doing?
Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm good.
Good.
So, Miss Nadia, our question is, what are some of the challenges that people face in terms of coming to you with an investment or with an idea? Has it been successful? Has it been like a trial where people have been frustrated and left back? Or what are some of the issues that your office faces in terms of this type of situations?
There's been some challenges. As a diasporan, you are coming to Ghana, you have a very limited time.
Yeah.
And people tend to know and then try to abuse that. What we have gone through so far, there's been some that have come back to the office and say, I'm just going back, nothing will work in Ghana, I'm not staying. And then the office is set up to encourage those things and to eliminate those things. Yes, there will be challenges. What I tell people all the time is, when we were coming to Canada, we didn't know how to wear winter gloves, we didn't know how to wear boots, we didn't know how to wear bat. We came and it was the mindset that this is our new home and we have to do everything to make it work. And if we have the same mindset coming back to Ghana with some creativity of what you want to do, either business or working in the, you know, civil society, everything that you want to do, once you have your mindset that this is what I want to do, it's going to be tough, but I have to remember that when I went to Canada, it wasn't that easy. You will make it work.
Yeah, that's true.
Indians have come and they've made it. Chinese have come, they've made it. And you as a Ghanaian, I think, should be the one to also make it work. So obviously there'll be challenge, but we are there to help support you. And then also, just don't turn around and run back when it's tough. Let us all help develop Ghana.
That's good. Thank you. So what are some of the encouragement that you can share with our viewers that have ideas that wants to come to Ghana and invest, or, you know, see the potential where they can come and invest? What are some of the encouragement that you can give to our viewers?
What I would tell the viewers is that Ghana is great. A lot of good things are happening in Ghana now. Africa as a whole is growing and you should be part of the movement. Canada have grown, Europe has grown, everywhere. Now everyone is looking at Africa, especially Ghana. Why? Because we have peaceful election, our country is very stable. We have an economy that is really rising. So let's all take advantage of this and come home with your creativity, your contacts, your network, and let's all help Ghana to be a better place that we can one day all be proud of.
Ideas, and some of them even spoke their frustration on certain channels that wasn't answered properly. So moving forward, as a collective and your team, is this something you guys are going to work on and make sure that the ideas that were spoken here today will be implemented, or some way be kind of like what took together as a community to make sure everything's working properly?
What we usually do is when we have these kind of meetings, we go back and we do a report for ourselves. And then in that report, we look at things that were being shared, solutions that can be, you know, come up with to help with this. What GCO is very good at is they always send us the report as well.
Yeah.
And we need to target, as we go back to Ghana, what are we going to do? What are we taking out of this? And also, we try to find solutions, because we are telling people to come to Ghana, come and invest, come and take part of the movement. However, there's still a challenge. So we have to look at those things and see how we can eliminate them to give a way for them to feel that when they come, the initiatives, the innovative ideas that they have are being looked into, even if it's not being accepted at the moment, but they are given the audience to be able to look into, whereby if the future potential to be able to look back and see, okay, you know what, let me look at this proposal again. Something that the office always, you know, champion on that.
Okay. That's great. The next question was in terms of, in respect to youth employment. I know there's a few young people that ask questions regards to youth employment. There are a lot of youth that have skills and ability to, you know, foster or look for a job. What are some of the strategies that your department and also the president's department are looking to work in terms of working to combat this issues that Ghana's facing right now?
So at the moment, the indigenous Ghanaians, what the government have done so far is we have the NEIP program, which comes under the Ministry of Business Development, so National Innovative Entrepreneur Program. That organization is to help youth with creative ideas to support them. We also have venture capital. Venture capital can give you a loan to start your business. You also have the National Youth Authority that can also give you up to, I think, about up to 10,000 to also start a business. That's someone who wants to start something on their own. What the government have recently, just May 1st, launched the NAPCO project, which is something that comes directly under the presidency,
yeah.
Where 3 years our youth are given the opportunity to be in the workforce to gain the experience while still getting some allowance, and that, you know, instill them to be ready for the workforce. Once you're done school, you do your national service and you still don't get employment, you can sign for the NAPCO, and then 3 years you are getting workable experience. And that's something that the government just did as well. What the government is also doing in other areas when it comes to diaspora youth is we have the diaspora internship program. So that with the internship program, what we are doing is we are making diasporans, youth second generations, to come home and have the experience of working.
Okay.
And with that, we connect you with various organizations, private, you know, public sectors, to help you to get to know what the workforce is in Ghana before you decide you want to move back. We also have the national service, international national service recruitment that has just started.
Yeah.
And I did mention earlier on my speech that as at now, we've had over 100 applicants that have applied for that program. So there's a lot of things that the government is seeing that the youth are going to be the big impact for Ghana development. And how do we do that? We have to empower them. We have to help them with creativity. And just before we came back, before I came to Canada, the business development again has just launched the presidential pitching program,
yeah.
Which is going to be the first one will be on July 6th,
okay.
And then the finale will be on July 11th. And again, that's also a program that is set for the youth to be able to be creative on their own way and get financial support from the government.
So I know a lot of people, this event that we just had this afternoon, I know a lot of people come here, share their ideas, and asking the government how or what ways can the government kind of support them. For me, my personal question is, how can we support Ghana? And all this information that you're relaying to our viewers, how can we share this information? How can we support Ghana to make Ghana a better nation and a better country? You know, a lot of people come here, they have their ideas, which is great. But for me, I'm asking you on a level where, how can we also support Ghana?
So what I tell people is, you know why? Once you think of something, even as a diaspora, you have your network. It's not everyone who is in Ghana that is fortunate to have that. Maybe just the company that you work with, certain networks that you have that you think might be an asset for Ghana, you connect with them. We have the diaspora office, which is set up for you, that is going to be your own, the who you know in Ghana. You connect with the office and we look at what you are presenting, and then we then connect you to the right ministry or agency that can, you know, help you throughout. And you were here, you saw some people, they testified to it.
Yes.
I tell people when they come to the office, my mandate is to assist diasporans not to go back and say, I'm not coming back to Ghana. That means I haven't done my job. I warn you, when you are sitting in the plane going back, you should be thinking of, okay, I'm going back to Ghana again. I'm going back to Ghana. And that's what we should all be,
that's,
you know,
true,
doing to make sure we promote Ghana, the positive things. And you heard them, Ghana is great. Chinese are coming and taking, the Indians are coming and taking. We should not be sitting in Toronto waiting for someone to come and develop Ghana for us. We as Ghanaians, especially the second generation, will have to go back and develop Ghana for our future and then for their future as well.
Okay. So we just wanted to ask our viewers, if someone, those that they couldn't make it today, if they wanted to come to your office, where is it located, or who can we kind of like get in contact with if they have ideas, those that are watching this and those that are going to be watching the event that happened, an amazing event that happened this this afternoon, where is the channel, where can we go to, like, you know, seek help? What kind of, like, departments and offices? Do you have any idea where somebody that might sit home and watch this say, you know what, I have an idea, maybe where do I go?
We have our office is located at the Jubilee House at Kanda, at the C block. When you come to Jubilee House, ask that you want to go to the Diaspora Affairs office. They will connect you in. We do not do like fixed appointment. Once you give me a call or give someone a call, director, myself or Yao, who is our office administrator, a call, or Jake, our office is, we have open door policy because that works for us. So you just have to make yourself available to come, and then we'll listen to you and see how we can be of help for you. We have a Facebook account, Diaspora Affairs Ghana. We have a Twitter account, Diaspora Affairs Ghana. We have an Instagram account as well. And I will share my phone number for you to share with the viewers as well.
That's great. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.